Welcome to The Brief.
Thank you, Tejbir, for joining us today. Before we get into the discussion regarding your experience of being in a joint venture with a foreign company, we would like to get to know more about you, about the ALP Group, and the work that you all have been doing in the product lines in Indian market as well as overseas.
ALP in India is primarily into rubber and plastic extrusion and molding business. Mostly application is the automotive industry, which is car manufacturers, bus manufacturers. Apart from that, we also have a company which does thermal and acoustic insulation for building and construction application in the HVAC and refrigeration industry. So that is the activity in India. And outside India, we have about six companies in US, Europe, Australia, and South Africa and Thailand, which are, some of them are manufacturing, some of them are distribution. So primarily the product is made, developed, conceived in India, and we try to sell it through these outlets, six outlets globally.
And these companies in the automotive space, both in India as well as overseas, are these primarily joint ventures that you are operating
we
in?
We have five JVs outside India, and we have three JVs in India.
And how has the experience been so far? Especially, you know, working with companies from different countries with different cultural backgrounds or with different business
see,
processes.
It depends. You see, the thing is that obviously every culture, every background is different. And as long as the partnership works to the strengths of both the partners and the basic understanding and trust factor is there, and the ultimate goal is the success of the business. So as long as these fundas are clear and the clarity is there, roles and responsibilities are defined and cleared, then I don't think any reason why it shouldn't work.
So typically at a starting point, right, let's call this the opportunity exploration stage. At this point, what are you all looking for in a JV partner?
If you are looking for a company in India, of course, we have to look at with respect to the what kind of technology they are bringing in, because that is why the JV is for, is that either we don't have that technology or we don't have that product line. So how good they are in that in terms of R&D, in terms of future, you know, technological changes and advances. And then most importantly is also how it is the background of the company, whether it is a family owned or it is professionally run or is it, you know, an MNC owned. And then also try to get more insight on their working behavior, their policies, their procedures. So these are some of the aspects if a company is coming to India. Now, when we go outside India, it's the opposite. So what we are looking at is a local support, somebody who understands the local culture, people, customs, administration, which we don't understand. So as long as we are able to find somebody with those required prerequisites, and also we have that factor of trust, that is what we look at when we go outside India.
It's actually interesting that you mentioned this point about, you know, how Indian SMEs are family owned and managed. And on the other hand, we do have the majority of MNCs that look to enter India have a management hierarchy. And it's this management that does have a conversation with the Indian. Are there kind of issues that typically arise when this is the equation that is kind of playing out? And what do you essentially do to kind of mitigate these issues?
See, every JV has some issues. But as I said, as long as the bigger picture is that we have to have a success and the trust factor is there.
So how do you build trust?
I mean, build trust is something which comes from the way your policies are, the way your procedures are, the how transparent the activity is. And how much interested is each party into the business, how much effort they are putting in. So from these factors, an entrepreneur can judge, you know, what is the involvement of the other party and what is the transparency they are working with. So with these factors, you can build whether there's a trust or there is no trust. So any SME coming into India, joining in an SME, yes, it's a family-run business. So more importantly for them is also, with apart from the numbers and the due diligence, whatever, they also need to check the background of the family in terms of their corporate governance, their compliances, their procedures and policies in the company, you know, and their management systems, you know, a background check on the management. So these are some things which should also be done before getting in bed with somebody on this.
And in a post setting up the JV is actually into operation. Are there checks and balances that are kind of put in place for the monitoring of the association?
See, the major, whenever you have a JV, it's your roles and responsibilities should be clearly defined. And as long as those roles and responsibilities are acted on and done, then I don't think any major issue comes, right? So post JV also, whatever you have agreed for each other to do, if that is being done properly and the transparency is there on both sides, then I don't think it's any issue there.
And what about the consideration that the local partner does bring a significant amount of value add and advantage to the table as compared to the foreign partner? So does this translate into any form of a premium in terms of equity or having a bigger say in how business is run locally?
See, it all depends on what business you are getting into. In our business, there is no premium for local partner.
Okay.
Right? Because if we are giving them support of local knowledge and administration and, you know, HR and all that, the other party is also bringing in technology and product. That is why we are getting together. So it depends which area of business are you in, whether you will get a local advantage premium or not. But in a country like India, yes, if you have somebody local here, it helps, because there are so many hidden facts and fundas here which an overseas person will not be able to understand. And we have different challenges here with our administration, with our compliances, with the government, and there's a frequent changing of policies and procedures. So local partner in a country like India with the administration here is definitely a very big advantage.
Do you all face similar issues when you all are going outbound? I mean, exploring foreign
markets?
Not
that much. Because if you are going outbound, we are going to the developed world, where the transparency is very clear from the government. Every data is available. All compliances are in place. All check charts are there. So we don't face that much of an issue when we are going outside. However, if we decide to go to a country like India, then we might face the same challenges.
I actually wanted to kind of go back to the point regarding trust. Trust is essentially not built only in the workplace, and in fact outside of the office. From your experiences with the various JVs that you all are in, how have you all worked to kind of create or build trust?
But it all depends, you know, it all depends on the human nature, you know. I mean, I like to invite my partners to my house over drinks, over mail.
And it does have a positive impact.
Of course. I mean, if I'm being open, then when I travel, I go, they reciprocate the same thing. So it depends on you as a character, how open you are and how comfortable you are. You know, if it's a purely professional relationship, then just maintain it professionally. But I think mixing both is also important in a JV, because you tend to get more closer to each other once you have and outside the office association also. So it all depends, I mean, upon your nature.
And does this only happen at a promoter level? Does it happen at lower?
At all levels, at all. Even in my company, I mean, if my overseas partners, they come, so our people will take them out for dinners or go out for drinks. So that's just to hope, because at the end of the day, promoter from his side or from my side are not involved day to day. The people below are involved day to day. So it's always better to know each other, the people involved. So it happens at all levels.
And these relationships that are being created and fostered will inevitably impact how quickly the learning curve kind of gets completed. Where JVs are instrumented in the case of bridging a technological gap, the new entrant will learn from the incumbent. How do you all take the association forward?
It all depends on the industry. I mean, again, you know, as I said, I mean, look at Maruti in 1984 when they came in. Government was at the top. Suzuki was a minority, and now it's the other way around. Government is almost out. So it all depends. I mean, how the promoter in India looks at his business. If he wants to be in the business, if he wants to exit the business, it all depends on person to person or company to company, or in fact industry to industry. So let's look at Toyota. When Toyota came in, they had a JV with Kirloskar. But once they are set in, today Kirloskar is not even maybe 5%, So it all again depends. In our company, we have had a 50-50 JV since 30 years. So it depends again on individual, on the promoter, on the industry.
So I would like to move my focus a little more on two challenges. Is consistently related to communication, especially in the scenario of an Indian company with a foreign company, the communication gap that prevails, and not just in language, but also with respect to the nuances. And the other challenge being different business processes that come into play. With experience, your thoughts on these?
See, it all depends how good you are transparent to your partner. So at the end of the day, what your partner is looking at, the books, So if you have a well-defined ERP system and it is compliant and there is a proper governance, then he has access to all that information. So he can obviously see what is happening day in, day out. They have access to the ERP system. They can pull out the record, right, and check. So most of the communication between the partners is towards the operations of the business. So if that chapter is cleared and it clarified, again it depends what kind of a company you are getting into it. So if a company has a proper compliance, they have governance, they have ERP systems, they have certain systems and procedures in place, communication becomes very easy. But a company which doesn't have all that, then the mistrust, distrust, those things come up, because you might say something, your figures might say something else. So it all depends on that, right. So that's
what the aspects that you'll sort of consider before actually getting into the JV.
Yes, it is very much required. So you need to fully understand what you are getting into, on what they are good, what they are bad. Whatever they are bad, can you correct that over a period of time? Can you fix that?
And is the partner open or willing to adapt to an alternative system to make JV happen and work?
See, when we look at, in a country like India, when you are calling somebody to come here, obviously we are looking at somebody which is better than us in terms of technology, in terms of systems, in terms of procedures. That is what we have done. We have not done a JV or brought in a partner which is, let's say, below us in terms of any of these aspects. So we've always looked at companies which are state of the art in their respective fields, in technology, systems, procedures. So as a group, we tend to learn a lot from them, and we in return try to adapt some of the systems here. So again, it all depends what you are getting into. Because this is somewhere, you ask for trust. Trust will come if your systems and procedures are in place. Nobody is on the face is written he is a liar or he is a true person. It is the deeds, the work what you do. So if there is an openness, so today all my JV partners have access to my ERP system. So that is the transparency we are working with. That is the openness. So ultimately, the trust also builds in.
Right.
We are not hiding any figure. We are not hiding any data. We have independent auditors selected by both partners. So that again, that trust factor is there. So you have to make something to have that trust and transparency. It cannot just come with your face.
But I'm sure these changes will not be blindly taken by either of the partners. Surely certain safeguards that one would take for oneself before getting into the joint venture?
See, again, for us, if you are looking at a company which is better than us, we also have to look out that tomorrow, once they are established, it would not be the case that we are no more there in the business, because obviously they have the muscle to take over. So that is something we try to protect our interest day one when we are making those agreements or negotiations, so that we ultimately do not, we see to this business on a long-term basis, right? So that is something we are very careful of on that aspect. And the second aspect is that done so many JVs now, we clearly understand that clearly defining roles and responsibilities is very important. So these two aspects, they stand out.
Especially given the invaluable experience that you have in the automotive manufacturing sector, both India and overseas, what is that one advice you would give other Indian companies who are looking to get into a joint venture with a foreign company?
See, I would say that apart from looking at the numbers, the balance sheets and the figures, they can easily be, you can do due diligence, legal check, background check, but you should also do it on the interested party as well. With respect to the management, what professionalism they have, what managements they have, what promoters they have, what policies and procedures they have, what systems they have in place, and do a background check on the, let's say, their, you know, like a just a viability, I mean, study about them in the market. So that gives you, I think that's important, because facts and figures could be different than what the behavioral or the operational or the procedure method is. So that is one advice I would like to give, is do a complete thorough check on the management systems procedures also in the company, because these could be some challenges which could have that ultimate mistrust or transparency issues in the future.